Hello, my fellow YouTubers and Minecrafters. It is KingCory100 here again. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make the 6-button combination lock like the other video. But this one's going to be slower and yeah, hopefully you guys can try it out. So this is an overview of it. It's pretty compact for 6 buttons. Alright, now let's get to the tutorial. Alright, you'll need some dirt, redstone torches, buttons, redstone dust, and repeaters. Alright, get a nice block of land. Start with the door frame. Okay, and here I'll put another row there. And go pretty far up. You gotta make a nice wall. Because this wall has to fit 6 buttons on it. 4, 5, 6. Perfect. So now we got our basic 6 buttons. Get a door, put it on there. Alright, so now let's start with the 4-digit button input. Okay? Alright. So put one down at the bottom each. We got basically delete that one for all of them. Yes, you should have those. Now put one redstone torch there on each of them. And then put them on the inside. There, there. Now put redstone dust connecting them to the top, just like that. One redstone dust underneath these. And repeaters on all of them. Now delete the dirt underneath the torch here. You'll see why soon. Okay, so that's basically the vertical iris knowledge for the buttons. Okay, now let's go to the reset switch. Let's put a dirt block there. Just dig under like this. So this is why we dug a hole, so we could see where the torches were. I think that's the last one. Yep. So now what you need is 3 wide room. If you have single player commands, this will make it much easier for instant mining. Delete these blocks here. Put a block underneath it there. Now basically wire them up just like this. Simple wiring. Nothing too advanced. Now what you need is to put one there. Put a dirt block in the corner. Redstone torch there. Now that's a inverter. It inverts the redstone signal. So it's basically the other way around. Okay, so now they're all on, as you can see. But test your reset switch. Doesn't work yet. Now you gotta add the redstone torches underneath here. So the wiring hooks up to the redstone torches. Okay, now test the reset switch. There you go, turns it all off. Now that that's done, now let's get to the open button. Basically 2 dirt blocks out, like this. And 3 blocks of dirt, redstone torches. There, there, and there. Redstone dust in the middle. Now, just say you wanted your code to be 1, 3, and 4. So basically, If they press 2, then they get it wrong. So you have to add. It's pretty simple. You just add a inverter. So a dirt block with a torch on it. That basically inverts the signal. There you go. So 1, 3, and 4. Now hook this. I think, yeah, you gotta add an inverter here. That, hook it up to there, and just basically hook this up to the door. To wire it up to the door so they can't see it, just delete this block here. So basically it powers this dirt block and that activates the door. So let's give it a go, reset it. So 1, 3, and 4. Let's check. Those three are on, except for that one. There we go. It works. Now, last thing is to add a indicator light, so you can see if you got it wrong or right or not. So basically, just add a torch there. Dirt blocks like that. Redstone wire. And you are basically gonna steal the. So when you do this, you should reset it. So you're gonna steal the output from. This one, yeah. Alright, now here you should add, I think it's an inverter. There we go. So just add another wall there so they can't see anything. Okay, so let's test it out. 1, 3. Alright, watch the lights off. 4. Turns on. So that means you got the code right. And the door opens. There we go. Yeah, so that's a basic 6-button, 4-digit lock door. The next tutorial will be the same thing, but very, very smaller.